You're the one who returned Blessed Shagorath. I would be honored to be wabberjacked by you, your grace. You have it, the Blessed Wabberjack. You must use it on me. You must.
Oh, do I have it? Do I have it? I don't have it. I know I don't have it. It's in my Breeze Home chest. Where else would it be? Oh, I was too focused on collecting Daedric artifacts and not losing them. And I had forgot that I probably should hang on to the Wabberjack in case this old crazy woman comes up to me. The first time I encountered her, she was telling me about Devenin. Devenin's, the master's on vacation, Devenin something something, go see Devenin, go, you know, that's what she was saying to me. And now I've, the second encounter with her is when she wants to be wabberjacked. And I see too many wabberjacks, and I don't know which one is the one. I don't want to break my game by, you know, cheating, using a cheat code to get it back. It's like, oh. So I ended up getting her ID, the woman's ID, teleporting back to Breeze Home using Lydia here, because she's a map marker item. And she's going to bed. Holy Moses. That's like a first in my game. So I came here, grabbed the Wabberjack, and my plan was to move the old woman here, since I have her ID. Easy peasy, you know, I do it all the time. Moving NPCs to where I'm at. And she's not here. Let's try again. Maybe she's, what? She's not here. I'm guessing she spawned out of the game. She's not a thing anymore. She's only there, and when you exit the scene, she goes away. She goes bye-bye. Oh. Oh well. I don't know how these people died here. I'm guessing a vampire attack in the night or something.
But you seem all right.
Wolves, maybe? Stumpy's alive because I made him essential.
Why, sure. Is that Asura Star? How did you come to possess such a rare thing?
So the old woman, I hear, is a repeating offense. She'll respawn again later in the game. So you get another chance to wabberjack her. So I made sure to get the wabberjack so I'd have it the next time I find her.
It's always good to see someone I can count on.
She looks like a hot mess.
Lady God, apologies. Hello, friend.
Anyway, that outfit he's wearing, I found a mod that,
all that I know.
Will help me put that outfit back on Aella. She keeps putting on her ancient Draugr armor. I'm not sure why that is. There's a scene in the game where you're naked, standing in front of Aella. And for whatever reason, the game wants to reinitialize Aella, you know, with a new outfit and everything. So whatever she had in her inventory before then, it's erased. It's gone. I mean, it's still there. It's just not her default outfit.
Wherever the Daedra hide, the Vigil of Stendarr will cast them into the light.
So I'm guessing there was a plan by Bethesda to have Aella as a werewolf with you, and that whole scene was chopped from the game. But they still reinitialize Aella for some reason. Because, you know, after the fact... Oh, I totally missed.
You're quite good with that. I thought I heard footsteps. Be careful.
Let's go kill us a necromancer or whoever's up there. When I had the bandit mods installed and the creature mods installed, it would always be a random person up here, but with vanilla, there's, it's always the same dude or dudette. I remember when these guys used to be tough and they would terrify me. I would just be scared to even come near this location because I was scared of necromancers. Now it's like, oh, easy killings. After a while of playing with a character, eventually my character becomes like any old character. I have become death. Yeah, that's basically what you are at level 50.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, got it that time. Oh, great timing, Driscoll. Sometimes my arm just doesn't want to lift the sword when I need it to. Oh well. It's all timing. It's all right foot, left foot. It comes down to that. Which foot was planted when I hit the power button? Who said that? Did the faithful lady say that?
Not good enough.
Is there anyone here? Hello? No one's here, I guess. We've come back too soon. Sometimes I do so much in a day in Skyrim that I forget that only a day's gone by. I may have to wait, you know, 3 days or whatever it is. A week. What's her face? I gave an outfit to Orisa, and now I'm wishing I didn't because it's not safe for work. So I have to minimize her appearance in the game. There was a point where Orisa lost all respect for me, and when that happens, guess what? You can't trade with her. And when she's wearing an outfit you can't have her wearing, you're kind of stuck until, you know, you earn her respect back. And that takes some doing. So now I know, when these people on the internet are saying, Orisa hates me, and no matter what I do, she still hates me, and I'm guessing these are millennials asking the question, because they just think, you know, sending an emoji to someone on their phone makes up for all the wrongdoing someone's done to somebody in their life. I said I'm sorry. I sent you an emoji of poop, a smiley poop. That makes everything all okay again with this, right? We're peas and carrots again?
Yes.
Oh. With Orisa, it takes a while. It takes a long while. So my suggestion, if I were to post an answer on the interweb on how to get Arissa to like you again, my suggestion would be just have Arissa follow you during the day as you do your chores. She needs to be near you so she can witness your amazing feats. So go and kill trolls. Go where you know there are trolls in the game. In Skyrim, kill the trolls. That's a mega deal with Arissa. If she sees you killing a troll, she just thinks that's the bee's knees. Another thing to do, not as often, it's not as common, and that's to kill dragons. She finds that very impressive as well. And then, do quests, be the good guy, help people with their problems. When you get XP, she gets respect of you. That's how it works. If you're not doing anything, if you're not getting any XP in the game for being a good guy, then yeah, of course she's going to hate you for the rest of the game. But, 20 years ago, kids in high school, especially the boys were calling girls hoes in high school. All of them, all the girls were called hoes. Hoes and bitches. I'm thinking, this is 20 years ago, I'm thinking, oh, this can't be good. This can't lead to good things. Sure enough, those teenagers are having kids at an early age, and their kids are teenagers now. And they're just a mess. They're a wreck. Being brought up by parents that call girls bitches and hoes. Anyway, these are the ones that are posting on Skyrim. Asking questions, how do I have a relationship with somebody in the game? Then you realize what bad parenting they were brought up with. So of course they've got... They're just clustered up, that's all. Now I know. Driscoll, what are you doing? You're comparing Skyrim with real life. On a very, 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 very generalized, basic... good guy, bad guy. If you understand good guy, bad guy, guess what? Your life is so much easier and less complicated, and your life just works. Everything just works.
Let's find that totem shield, brother.
When you know good and evil.
I'll take my leave, then.
If you don't know good and evil, then guess what? You're screwed. You're just taking up space on the planet. You're just a carbon footprint, as far as most Democrats would be concerned. Maybe they want you to be that way. They don't want you to think. They just want you to vote every 4 years for Democrats. That's all you're good for, is because you don't know good and evil. Like that guy. What was that? Oh, what's the guy's name? The guy who was semi-famous for writing, screenwriting, producing, directing, all that. The Guardians of the Galaxy movies. Without him, Guardians of the Galaxy would not be what it is. It would not be a thing at Comic-Con. Comic-Con's in full swing today in San Diego. All the trolleys are dressed up for the occasion with big old placards saying, this way to Comic-Con. Take the trolley to Comic-Con. That's what downtown's hoping people will come into downtown today. We're waiting. Finally. Faceplant. So anyway, it's the guy, you know, the guy, I guess the guy was supposed to be at Comic-Con talking about his vision for Guardians of the Galaxy 3, which he's been writing. It's supposed to be out in 2020. Well, he was fired from Disney a couple days ago. You know, he's a typical Hollywood guy, so I'm thinking, okay, what did he do? I mean, what does a Democrat have to do to get fired from Disney? And I went on his Twitter feed. The guy's got like 10,000 tweets. The guy is just a tweet machine. And every tweet he spews out is hate. It's like, I almost want to say, you know, speaking in Democrat terms, I want to say each of his tweets is a hate crime. Hate speech. It's all hate speech. Anyway, he's got like 10,000 posts of nothing but contempt for the good guys in the world. So apparently, it was the total sum of his tweets that got Disney to take a look at his future employment with their company, or not. Because if you take his Twitter page as a sum, it's evil. It just rounds down to just plain simple evil. So they said, bye-bye. They don't even care. Disney doesn't even care who's going to direct or write or anything about Guardians of the Galaxy 3. They've got the Infinity War Part 2 and 3 and 5 and 6 and all that. They can live on forever. Because, you know, nerds, neckbeards, fat neckbeard nerds with fanny packs and the diabetes, those are the people that chronically go to see those kind of movies. They want to laugh. They want to go see a icon character on the screen and have laughs. Yeah, I remember when I read comics, superhero comics, and how funny they were and how I laughed my ass off reading the comics. No, that never happened. Yeah, I don't remember ever laughing while reading a Iron Man comic or Captain America, Spider-Man, Hulk, She-Hulk, Thor, Fantastic Four.
Good to see you.
Anyway, I never saw the Guardians of the Galaxy movies.
Make me proud.
I never read the comics, so I don't know anything about it. But I don't like it when someone gets fired like that. But that's the world we live in now. Because, you know, Democrats. Democrats run the world. The rest of us have to figure out how to make a living, how to have a life, how to do the good things that need to be done still, without interference. Democrats, they spend every waking moment trying to figure out how to control other people. And, you know, get them arrested for thought crimes. Now there's old school Democrats. That's a whole other thing. Old school Democrats would be like John F. Kennedy or Donald Trump. Donald Trump, lifetime Democrat. He decided to join the Republican Party and run for president. His chances were better doing it that way. because he's an old school Democrat. An old school Democrats. If you think about it, they were conservative.
I find this a bit scary.
JFK was conservative.
Are you hungry?
Compared to Democrats around now.
All right.
Democrats around, you know, these days, Democrats are just full on Marxists, socialists, communists. In the worst degree. The worst. You know, they kill their own babies. And if you're against killing babies, then you're a Nazi. You're Hitler. Racist. So this is said by all the fat neckbeards with fanny packs at Comic-Con. They'll tell you in a sentence how they love comic books, they love superheroes, but yet they are totally for killing babies. In one breath.
You want something from me? Until next time.
That's how delusional people are now. And those are the customers of Disney superhero movies now.
This better be good.
You know, because Hollywood. Everyone loves a Hollywood star because they made it. They got famous. And that's another thing a Democrat is always after, is to be famous. Not significant, but famous. Whoever dies with the most likes and the most followers wins. That's weird. Looking for the door to the mine. Where is the mine? I thought I could just run up the bridge. Boom, there's the door. Go into the mine. Yes? No? I like how this is all set up, though. It's got, like, all these little areas, living areas. It's even got a bed. If I remember right, there's a bed outside. Finally, I gave up. Get my torch out. It's just that sometimes the blizzards up here will blow my torch out. So I gotta hurry up and do my licky-looing. Oh, there it is. See, there's a bed here. Isn't that weird? Orcs! My next character is going to be an orc. After seeing, when people ask, Triskel, why are you playing an orc this time? Well, because they have beds outside. I mean, bandits do as well, but it makes sense for bandits. Orcs have homes, but why do they have a bed outside if they have home? You know, bandits usually have beds because their house burned down. Because they trashed their place. Orcs seem to have good upkeep with their real estate. It's very decorative. Anyway. Oh, there's a bridge around here I need to take. I don't want to, like, fall to my death. I've done that. I've gone running off a cliff in the dark, thinking, oh, that bridge doesn't go over anything deep, does it? And I fall into the uncanny valley. I wanted to go visit Cora while I was here, but I think I saw her for like a hot second. When I saw her, she had gone feral. I let her loose here because that's where she's from, and she reverted back to her basic needs. She's not the civilized companion in Whiterun she used to be. I thought I'd make her into a lady. But no. So we're looking for a cave. All I remember is the cave has a table out in front where they do some sort of sacrificing stuff. I want to say these are necromancers that live in the cave. One of them's having issues already. Oh, killing a goat? Some sort of goat killing cultists, that's what they are. So did I see my Wabbajack in my inventory? I have it in case I ever see that woman again. We were just sneaking at that. Oh, I see. She was going after all kinds of animals and then just happened to accidentally run into us while chasing after an animal. Okay. So she didn't just notice this in the dark like that. Where's her body? It's around here somewhere. If I remember, I think she died underneath the saber cat. Yeah. I used to have a mod called Immersive NPC in the Dark. It was kind of a cool mod. But the whole torch scripts for NPCs was crazy. Too many people had torches inside the taverns. Inside the merchant stores. It drove me nuts. So I had to get rid of it. I wish it would get fixed one day.